Okay, so this video recording is going to be on my facing the final doorway, which my teacher, Dr. David R Hawkins, went through, which is the final ego death, when one just stays in that state and there is no return of ego or enlightenment or self-realization, however you want to describe it, when the ego finally dissolves. And my experience of that, so I was following a self-inquiry teacher here in London on going to the observer or the witnesser or who am I, and it was myself. And I had we so I had spoken to connected with I actually spoke to Susan, Dr. David R. Hawkins. I didn't want to go to America. I wanted him to come to London. I won't go into the story. Dr. Hawkins to come to London to give a talk. And I said I'd organize the whole venture for him. So I did speak to Susan and she said, okay, you can organize something. And I went to, it was going to be in, and I went, and then Veritas Hawkins, they gave me some contacts in London who might be able to help me set up this lecture for Dr. Hawkins to come to London. And there was one guy and one woman. And we met regularly and ran a spiritual group, a sort of Hawkins, A Course in Miracles group. And we were organizing, no, I think it was another gentleman as well, organizing the talk for Hawkins to come. I went to, what's that, St. James's. Yeah, they said, yeah, Hawkins, we'd love to have him talk. So I was organizing everything. I was getting to speak to Hay House, they were going to be involved and all of that. And then, oh yeah, I'm digressing a bit. Anyway, so we were all involved with that and would also meet up regularly to watch Hawkins material and Muji's DVDs and Hawkins DVDs as a group, because I introduced them to Muji. We were all Hawkins fans and they loved Muji and the self-inquiry, and we all loved Hawkins as well. So we just watched videos together. And there was a video of Muji, and he was talking about going through, he didn't call it the final doorway, but he called about, you know, he called it the burning, you know, to burn everything off with the ego until it's fully burnt off. And he was saying, like, cut your thoughts off, cut the past off, cut your identity off. He's making these kind of slashing, like a samurai warrior, like you no longer need to hold on to anything that your ego cherishes. And I was like, as he was talking, I was watching transfixed, and it was like my ego was being like sliced, was being sliced, like let it go. He said it with such authority, like just let all of this stuff go, let everything go. And he was just slicing away at all the ego's foundations with this kind of vigorous action with his hands. And then suddenly there was a terror, an absolute terror. And I realized this wasn't the usual terror. It's not a terror. You know, it was the terror of the final death, that if I was to go through this absolute terror of ego death, that it would not reemerge again. I would lose my identity and what I thought I was my whole life, to surrender my life as I understood life. And I would not be able to return from this. It would be the final doorway and my ego would not be able to regenerate. It was absolute blinding terror. And I knew this was not the normal types of fears of death or other concerns. So it's like a visceral terror. And then immediately as the thoughts came up, and there was the other two, it was like suddenly there was like tears and crying. And my ego said, I mean, it sounds so stupid, but it's the truth. My ego said, you cannot allow yourself to start bursting into tears in front of the other two people. And I latched onto that thought, and it was like suddenly the doorway was slammed shut, like, okay, you've chosen your ego. So, and the terror went, and it was like I was returned to my ego. And then, and I refused the gate because I latched onto this thought with everything I had, identified on with this thought that I don't want to cry and I'm going to control the situation and force myself not to cry. And it was like this doorway of grace that was opening up to dissolve my ego was like, it seemed like it was shut. Okay, you've chosen now. You didn't want to go through, so you're not going through. The opportunity is gone. And it was so mystical, this thing, because the other two people had the exact same experience as I did. So we all felt this huge terror of our ego about to dissolve. So it wasn't just myself, all three of us at the same time. And there was the gentleman, I won't name him today, but you know, we went off to see Hawkins together and Muji many times. And he has a son. And as that terror of his ego dissolving came upon him, he refused it because he had a son to support. And he said he could not, because he might leave the body, he might bliss out, he might not be able to function. He latched on like, I can't leave my son and my ego. I have to keep my ego intact. And he, and then the terror stopped. He wasn't allowed, he didn't go through. And there was a woman there, and she also had the terror. And then she said she had refused it, and I've now forgotten it. This was about 20 years ago, exactly why she refused the terror. So we all had this collective terror of the death of our ego, and we all picked. Now, what can I share that can be of use? And I got this from Hawkins. You never know when suddenly there might be a huge terror that you're going to, your ego is going to die if you go through it. And actually, it's more easy to refuse and not go through that dissolving of the ego until it's completely dead and dissolved forever. The last is like the key fears, the key core of it dying, to not willingly go through that. And it's like within a split second, if you identify with a thought or anything that is like a refusal to go through that fear, it's like I felt like the door was shut, like I've refused it now. You had your chance and you didn't want to go through because you didn't want to cry. And the other, he didn't want to be functionless and look after his son and the woman as well. We all refused it. So my thing is like, you could pray for willingness. You could like with all your heart, if a huge terror arises that your ego is going to dissolve, if you want enlightenment, you want grace forever, and you're willing to sacrifice whatever it takes to go through that final terror, then you just prepare yourself. Do not latch onto any thought that is refusing to go through. Whether you cry, whether, I mean, these are the major things. Like if you can't function and you go into a state of bliss, never to speak again, and you've got a son that's dependent on you, you can't do that. You just have to hold on to your ego. You can't release yourself until all your dependents are gone. So you have to work through what are your fears that you cannot let go completely to God and trust. You know, well, I have to pay the bills. I have to look after my children. You know, I might die, I might leave the body, I might just sit here bliss like a vegetable forever, I might turn into Ramana and be eaten by flies unless some devotees find me. All kinds of thoughts may come in, so you know, because God bless them, being blissed out, not aware of while flies are biting you, I mean. Anyway, so all these kinds of fears do come up, and if you're not willing, and the ego will choose the fear that will make you not go through. What are you? I mean, the things I learned are, what are my biggest fears? And would I be willing to sacrifice them completely if God gave me an invitation to dissolve my ego? So if you work on those, and when a chance comes, you hope that you're not going to pick up the temptation of your ego refusing the doorway. It's a lovely question. Thank you so much.